Hi folks, Tim Walking Bear, the Plant Whisperer here. As you all can see, I shaved. Now my native elders always said, when Tim shaves, it's a sign of spring coming. So maybe we're in for some luck and the spring will be around the corner. Well, you all know my situation. I posted videos left and right, keeping everybody informed of what's going on in my life. So you all know that the church people have succeeded in getting me kicked out of Nana's house. Me and my kids got 2 weekends together before the evil ones came and destroyed that. Luckily, Jesus is good, and Jesus provides. And I was able to hook up a place to stay. And a little bit of work. So Jesus comes through, even when his so-called followers stray from the path and don't do what they know they should do. Speaking of the Advent Church here in Norgewalk, Maine, yeah, you might hint, might be a hint of bitterness in my voice. I don't hold anything against the Advent Church itself. These are just the actions of a few misguided souls that happen to be members of this church. Although they are using it, they use the church in their favor to get their way. These people should be ashamed of themselves. Scaring an old lady into thinking it's a sin for me to be there to help and care for their home. That they're going to lose their home because somehow it's a violation of the reverse mortgage, or me to be there as a caretaker, which is total bullshit. Both counts. It is perfectly fine for a gentleman of my age to be a health care provider for an elderly woman. In fact, I was working with one of the state health care workers that comes to the house and sees Caroline. She likes me a lot, and she was helping me learn what I need to know to be a care provider. And she was paving the way for me to actually do it as a living. And this whole idea that an older man being in your home and caretaking you is a sin in the eyes of the church, that's total BS. Jesus would approve. I did the Christian thing by trying to help this old lady take care of her home and her cats and herself. And she did the Christian thing by giving me a place to live. And a place to visit with my children. I had 2 visits with my children, and then it all gets yanked out from underneath me. My mail's being returned. I've lost money because I have a internet business that I was just starting to get back up online, being at Nana's. And I started getting some sales. I sell some of my dream catchers and some of my crafts. Chance to make a little bit of money. That's yanked out from underneath me by kicking me out of Nana's house. I was getting my, gotta have an address to get my food stamps and my Medicaid going. And I need my teeth worked on. And I was getting all that situated at Nana's house. I've been using that address as a mailing address for over a year now because it's a place where I felt I could securely get my mail because Nana always had my mail for me. And now these church people got Nana thinking she's sinning by having me around, and that she's going to lose her house to the reverse mortgage people by having me around. So they kicked me on the street, and now they're sending back all my mail. So I've lost out on sales that I've made on the internet with my business, and I've lost out on being able to get my health care and my food stamps up and running again. Well, now I'm in another place, and I'll start working on all that stuff all over again. It just totally boggles my mind that a couple of people that are part of the Adventist Church here in Norgewalk take it upon themselves in the name of Jesus to kick this man, me, out of Nana's house. She's got Nana scared half shitless that she's going to go to hell for me being around and that she's going to lose her home. What the hell kind of people is that? That is not what Jesus would do. And it's not like I'm some bum off the street that Nana never knew that she just picked up and brought home. That's not the case at all. I was going to marry her daughter less than a year ago. I've been involved with this family for a while. I am a part of this family. Her grandson, Jacob, looks up to me like an uncle, and I do a lot of things with him, and we got a good relationship. I got a really good friendship with Nana's daughter, the woman I almost married. And I've always had a good relationship with Nana. Anytime she needed something fixed around the house or something done, I was always there for her. She was like the big sister I never had. And for the church people to go and do this, it just blows my mind. It's unbelievable. Well, Saturday is when they have their service. I'm going there next Saturday, and I'm going to sit through their service. And if they have a time when they have open testimony, I'm going to get up, and I'm going to get to the podium, and I'm going to talk. And I'm going to pray for these people. It'll be good. I won't be mean or anything. But I will touch this person's heart, the people's hearts that are infected with the darkness that has caused this to happen. What goes around comes around. Jesus takes care of his own. Jesus has taken care of me, making sure I'm not on the street and I got food in my belly. And Jesus will take care of Nana and help heal her and bring her home and get her in the right frame of mind. I do not hold any of this against Nana. I love Nana, and I always will, and I'll always be there for her. It's these church people, these few in the church, that are fanatical and have taken it upon themselves to manifest what has happened. And they will be held accountable by their own karma. What goes around comes around. I pray for them too. I pray that Jesus fills their heart with the light of the love of the Holy Spirit and guides them to a more Christian walk. You don't give a man a food box one day, kick him on the street the next, take away his only place and opportunity to see his children. This has hurt those kids. Not only these my own kids, but Nana's own grandson, Jacob. He has a room in Nana's house. And Jacob's mom drops him off every now and then to spend the night with me, sometimes 2 or 3 days with me. He's always had the security of having his room at Nana's. And either Nana or Tim being around so that he could go there in times of need. His mom's in the middle of a move. She sometimes needs to drop Jacob off for a little while so she can get things done. So these church people have not only taken my home and taken my visitations away from my children, but they've also taken away Jacob's room, her own grandson's room, and the security he had in having that place. It's not right. And all in the name of Jesus, these people are not working in the name of Jesus. They are deceived. And I hope that their hearts get opened and that they start doing things differently. Jesus would not do this. And Jesus was all about loving each other, taking care of each other. Not about scaring the hell out of each other, putting people on the streets, and things like that. 3 little kids and 1 man have been adversely affected by the actions and decisions of members of the Advent Church in Norridgewock, Maine.